Today, we're going to make a pair of Robert pants. These pants are great. They're really easy. They can be lined or unlined. We're going to do them lined because that's probably of the two ways, that's the most difficult. But they really are a super easy pair of pants. And I'm going to start by, I still have my pattern pieces on my fabric. And the main thing I want you to notice is there are two cutting lines for the main fabric and for the lining. So as you can see, your lining, the pants are going to be shorter for the lining than they are for the outer fabric. So when you are doing this pattern, be sure and read the information that's on the pattern itself because it's very important. And so we're just going to start along, and I'm just going to let you follow along with your instructions if you'd like, and that way you can make any notes. So I'm going to take some of the pattern pieces off now. So I want pockets in these pants. It's optional, but we're just going to go ahead and do pockets. So there's a template that comes with the pattern too. So it's not a pattern piece, it's a template. And this is your pocket curve. So I'm going to pin it on here just a little bit better. And you don't use this template for the lining, only for the outer fabric. So as you can see, that is step five. Then we're going to move on to the pocket itself. And there's a pocket piece and a pocket lining piece. The pocket lining piece is the piece that looks like this. And it goes right sides together, right along that same curve that you've just cut. Pins there. This one will go on the other side. So we're going to start by sewing the pocket lining to the pocket curve. This is a 1/4 inch seam. Now, your pattern tells you to clip into the seam at the curve. And then with our iron, we're going to press the lining to the inside, wrong side, of the pants. And if you will press it with the lining of the pants facing up and kind of roll that seam so you can see a little bit of the outer fabric, you'll have a nicer finish on the outside. We'll do that with this one. So, if you wanted to, you could stitch corded piping on the curve of the pants before you do the lining, and then you'd have a nice little accent. These are, this is a fabric for girls, and that would add something cute with this fabric. Okay, the next step, still working with the pockets. So this is how it will look when we get it stitched in just a little bit. It'll look like that. So that's how the pockets formed. But when you sew this part, you lift the lining up away from the actual pants fabric. So you'll just be stitching through these two pocket pieces, the pocket lining and the pocket. So now, in step 5, we need to just baste across here and across here. And that's just to hold all of this in place until the side seams are on and the front band of the pants is on. So now I'm just going to repeat with the other pocket. Okay, now we are ready for step 6 and 7. And those are going to be the center and back crotch seams. So right now, it's like you're making two pair of pants. I'm just going to go ahead and pin them all and then stitch them all. And this is with right sides together, but our lining fabric doesn't have a right or wrong side. But this fabric does. Okay, here we go. I don't know if you ever do this, but when I'm sewing several pieces that are all pretty much the same thing, I just leave a little tail and then I'll cut them apart later. It seems to speed the process a little bit. So now we're going to clip the curves here and press these seams open. Nice to have a small iron at your sewing station if you have room. We're going to do that with all the center seams back and front. Switch this. There. Now we are ready for step 8, and that is the waistband. You have both a lining and an outer fabric waistband. And again, it's right sides together. And then the same thing for the lining. Be sure you don't sew your waistband to the back of the pants. Make sure I don't have it to the back of the pants. This up a little bit. Now we're going to press the waistband. The seam allowance will be pressed up as well as the waistband itself. So now we're on to step 9, and that's the side seams. When you're pinning, if you'll pin right where the seam allowance of the waistband is pointing up, it won't get pushed down the wrong direction. Now we're going to press the seams open, which is a little hard to do with this iron on this ironing board. I think I'm just going to press it to the back. Which may be what the instructions say to do, actually. This would be much easier with a regular ironing board.